Hey guys, how's it going? This is Christopher John Hill. Good to see you all today. And today I'm going to be showing you the three best hotspots to farm in Guild Wars 2. I've been playing the game since the game release, and away we go. Basically, this latest farming spot, which I'm going to show you, or the latest two farming spots I'm going to show you, have been in the game for a very long time. However, with the implementation of the Ascended Cooking, level 500, you can now have access to farming seeds. And seeds, from what I can tell, and have been quite successful at, have been the greatest farming resource in the game that I have found so far, and the most efficient. Basically, if you're looking for something that's fast to farm and that you're going to get quickly, then this is it. This is what you're looking for, mature herbs. And what I'm using is a consortium harvesting sickle with the Glyph of Bounty, which gives 33% more chance to gain an extra strike. I am also using the item booster. This also further increases the yield that you're going to get of these. And so here we go. Okay, so I got one of those from that one. And these sell for roughly around between 20 and 30 silver usually per seed, which is quite a lot. And it basically varies, it fluctuates, but usually you're not going to sell it for any less than around 18 silver per seed. And if you have 70 characters, this adds up extremely quickly, which gives you guys a lot of gold really fast in a very short amount of time. And the more characters you have doing it, the faster you're going to make gold. And this is how I afforded 70 characters in the game. I'm no joke, guys. I've got 70 characters. Go back to the beginning of the video and you'll see that I have 70 character slots. This is how I afforded every single one of them. I just kept doing it on each character and consistently, and eventually you'll get there. Okay, so basically the areas that you'll locate these in are, the first one is the map that has the Shatterer Dragon, of course, at the top right hand corner where the Terra Karonda waypoint is. And basically you're going to find them all the way at the top here, all the way around that whole area there. Sometimes they'll be right next to each other, other times they'll be spread out. But you'll always find them here, three of them in total. I've already farmed one of them earlier, so I only showed you two. Okay, I'm going to show you another area, which is also worth farming, which is in Queensdale. So we're going to head there now. It's near the Beetle Farms. Okay, so let's head towards the area that you will find them in. This is another hotspot that has been basically, it's become viable since the patches and the release of Ascended Cooking. The seeds are a very valuable resource and they're worth a lot of silver. This one has the other one, which is the second highest seed that you can sell, well, consistently in the game. And this one is the Veritol Peppercorn Seed. So there it is. That one will usually sell for about 15 silver each. And it's also another option which you can go for, especially if you have characters which are lower in level. This is a definite option as well, and you'll usually find them spread across the map, generally across the middle of the map. This one's a bit more work to, a bit more legwork to get to each one. But if you're willing to do it, it adds up over time, and it sells for more silver in the game than most other things. Well, practically most other things in the game are not as worth as much for the effort invested. So I highly recommend it. You'll usually find them throughout the middle of the map. I'm gonna just quickly go through and show you the general locations you'll find them at. Everyone recognizes this location. It's where the humans start out against the centaurs. And there's nothing there at the moment. So we'll keep moving ahead. And hopefully we'll find something at the end here. And for anyone that plays Guild Wars 2, there's going to be a lot of people that are fans of characters like Queen Jenna. I'm a big fan of her. And I wanted to create a cosplay version of her, which is, a very elegant and beautiful, of course. I think I succeeded at that. So, let's head to the end section here and see if we can't locate where these other spots are. Okay, so that's the carrots. That's not it. That's not what we're looking for. Quickly running out of spots. Of course, it's in the last spot. There it is. Got it. I could outrun a centaur. Okay, so that one was located just outside the township of Claypool. And then we have one more, which I'm still trying to locate. I'm not sure if I'm going to find it, but we're going to give it a go anyways. Let's see if we can locate it. Here we go. There it is. Gotcha. Okay, so basically, guys, every time you search for these, you're not always going to find, five of them in a row. Sometimes you'll find one, sometimes you'll find two, sometimes none. Usually, on average, you're going to find between three and five of them per character. So I'm going to show you the last spot now, the last hotspot which I know of, which makes good gold in Guild Wars 2, which is, of course, Siren's Landing. This place has been pretty popular for a while now. You're not going to find the highest selling item here, but it is pretty easy to get a hold of it, and pretty successfully and consecutively if you've got a lot of characters. So I shall show you why this one is so popular. Most people probably already know, it's because of the coral. So we have three coral spots, which are very fairly near each other, and sometimes right next to each other, and you're looking for the coral orbs right down there. And if you go down here, usually you'll find the other two. Here's one right here. And then there should be one more directly ahead. There it is. As I said, guys, these are not always next to each other, but they're very easy to farm, very quick, very fast, very efficient, and they make you a lot of gold really fast. As you can see, I've afforded a lot of pricey stuff in a very quick amount of time. So to end this video, I'm just going to quickly show you how Queen Jenna looks with the slider bars, and I'm also going to show you what I've purchased on the town trading post. So let's do the trading post first, and then I'll show you the total makeover so you can make a Queen Jenna for yourself if you like. Okay, so basically my transactions, I'm going to show you a quick history of what I bought. There we go. The permanent hairstyles contract, which was 1 month ago, and then all these other nodes, which I also purchased not too long ago. So as you can see, this type of farming can be very profitable very quickly, and you're going to make thousands of gold in next to no time. It's very quick to do it, very easy, very fast, very efficient. So I highly recommend it. It's how I got all my 70 character slots, and I bought them all also when they went on sale. So I'm going to show you the total makeover now for Queen Jenna. So if anyone's interested, you can have a look at that for that as well. I believe this is a height of 5 on here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, it's 5. Right here we have the body that's basically all the way to the left, and then one to the right from the top. You have the caramel skin color. And then as for the head, it's right next to this one right here. The hair, nightshade. And it was this one right here, which is basically below that one. And next to that one. Okay, and on this one it doesn't really matter because it doesn't really show up. I have illumination on that one. And here are the sliders. Eye to the angle to the left, iris to the right, to the middle. Eye size, height to the right, to the middle, left, left, left. And then you have the brown eye color. For the nose, we have all these. You can pause the video when you guys want to look at it, if you want to make one. You have the lips right there, and then you have the rest of it, the head width and everything else. Okay, I'm going to quickly go to the throne room. You guys have a quick look. So you can make a comparison. And as I said, guys, you can buy the item booster, which will help increase the overall yield. And the bounty, the glyph of bounty is the one I would definitely go for. So, here we are. We have two Queen Jennas. They look identical. And I shall remove the UI, just so you can have a look. There you have it. And I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you liked it, please leave a like and subscribe. I'm also a writer, so my name is Christopher John Hill. I'm on Amazon, I'll leave a link for that down below. And cheers, guys. Happy farming, and I hope to see you again next time. See you later. Bye.